What's going on, everybody? This is your favorite pirate, Captain Fox. I'm back at it again with Kingdom Hearts. We are en route to the last world. I'm pretty sure this is the last scummy mission that we ever have to do. Thank God. But anyway, as you can see, things get really heated later on. This is crazy. Look at all these things that can kill you. Those block things that look like the remnants of some kind of giant spaceship, they're not... I don't think those can kill you. I mean, enough of them will, but... But holy hell, there's so many things on screen right now. Those things can kill you. Those huge things, I'm pretty sure these huge things will kill you also. But they're so tough, like that armor that they have on, like, I'm not even trying to shoot them right now because I wouldn't even be able to defeat them. There's literally no point in me trying to shoot those things. So, I think these missions get shorter and shorter each time because... there it is, the final world, and it's conveniently called End of the World. So let's see what this world has to offer. Ooh, this looks interesting.
Is that all that's left of the worlds taken by the Heartless?
Gross.
Those worlds will be restored if we beat Ansem, right?
You betcha!
But if we do beat him, and all these worlds become restored and disconnected, what's gonna happen to this place? And to us?
Well,
this is a Heartless world, so maybe it'll just disappear.
Huh?
But no worries. Even if this place goes poof, our hearts ain't going nowhere. I'm sure we'll find our pals again. Yep, I just know that we will.
Good old Goofy.
Yeah, you're right.
Cheering everybody up.
I'll return this. I promise.
I don't know if that's a promise you can keep, Sora. But anyway, that weird cut that you just saw, I potioned everyone up, so we should be good. And here we have the Invisibles. These awful, awful enemies. As you can see, they're a bit bullet spongy, at least right now anyway, because I think I'm level 50 something. I think I'm 56 right now. So, like, half as strong as I could be. But strike rate seems to do the job pretty well. Nice, Gales. I didn't know those guys gave you Gales too. I thought only the shiny, the angel looking ones gave you Gales, but I guess not. There it is. Oh no, I don't have a command menu. Shit. Oh. Okay. So those don't actually exist in that other world, I guess? I hope they don't, because then I just missed the treasure that I don't think I'll ever get back. So in here, all you gotta do is, well, these little island things, well, oh, okay. You never mind that a swirling ball of darkness just came out of a treasure chest, but... So those little, like, pieces of island thing, they kind of look like... To me, they kind of look like arrows. So you just follow them... I'm sorry, the reason that I'm following them is because there are invisible walls, so you can't just run straight to the end, you have to kind of follow that, like, path. Like, where those... The islands are pointing. And I didn't target anybody. Great. Sorry, my controller's a bit fucked up, so. Funny story, I accidentally stepped on my PS2 controller, and now I can't push down. Like, I push down and nothing happens. So I can only, up. So I can only scroll down. It's kind of annoying. So I ordered another PS2 controller, so, like, hopefully it'll get here before I do the end of Kingdom Hearts, because I especially don't want to do the boss rush, fight Sephiroth and everything with a busted controller. Because that'll be like extra hard mode. And of course we gotta fight, I'm pretty sure we fight this thing. These are called behemoths, if I didn't mention that before. I'm pretty sure we fight like 10 of these throughout the whole game. Like if you do 100%. Because for some reason, the game just loves throwing these at you at the end of the game. And they get less and less dangerous each time, so I kind of don't see what the point is. I never dodged that fucking attack. Never. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I can never dodge that freaking attack. Get up. Oh, God. I hate the platforming. You're right, and as soon as I get up here, he's about to do that move. Oh, shit. That definitely would have KO'd me if I didn't have a second chance on. Come on. Get up. Come on. Ah, of course. So every time this guy takes a step, you can, you'll get hit if he hits you. If you're fast enough with your combos, yeah, like that, you can stagger him. And so he won't do that, what do you call it? I forgot what the technical term for that attack is. But he's almost gone. He's already on the yellow health bar. And I fell off. Great. See, now that I have second chance on, I really don't have to pay as close of attention to my health as I used to. See, because just that one move takes out more than half. And then getting hit by one of those dark orbs takes out the other half. But because I have second chance, I have that time to heal. Do you hang on by one HP point? And there's another one. It's not an ability in this game, but it's in the second one. I think it's called Once More. I think that's what it's called. Where you'll survive any combo with one hit. And it's pretty useful against Sephiroth. Because Sephiroth's got, once you get him low enough, he'll start doing these, like, 8-hit combos that, like, if you get hit by the whole thing, you're just kind of dead. Well, an easy way to avoid those dark orbs is if you just, like, go underneath him, and he'll kind of shield you from them, from his own attack. But you gotta be careful, though, because you can't just hide under there when he's charging it up. And that was pretty cool. Just getting to hang out in midair like that. I'll take it. Nice! I got another Omega Arts. So, yeah, I just cut to the part where I equipped it both. Because Omega Arts is actually really nice, and to get an Omega Arts at that behemoth battle, it's something like a ridiculously low percent. I think it's like under 10% chance that he drops an Omega Arts, so I got really lucky there. Which is nice, because now I got two Omega Arts. And these are, I always call these the Angel Heartless, even though I'm not sure that's what they're called. Like, in the game, but... Oh, and see this bullshit? They put their wings over their bodies and they're, like, invincible from, I think they're invincible to magic, too. I'm not sure, but they're definitely invisible to, physical attacks. When they, like, close their wings over their body. Angel Bangle. So as you can see, I'm just following these, like, triangle pieces. This level is actually, I think it's really cool. Like, it looks really freaky. It looks like you're just kind of floating in the sky. See, when I first played this game, I thought that there was just no ground and you had to, like, jump and... You had to, like, jump and glide to get to the little pieces. Because it legit doesn't look like something you can walk up. I'm really surprised that the strike rate reached all the way over there. So, these guys, their stabbing attack, or their thrust stabbing attack, does a lot of damage. That shit will kill you. Kill you dead. Nice, defense up. I'm probably playing really... I remember playing this game when I was little, and using, like, okay... If I have three defense ups, I give one to Sora, one to Donald, one to Goofy, and, like, reverse them. Okay, so the next strength up, I'll give to Donald, and blah blah blah, but in this run, I'm just like, nah, they're all mine. They are all mine. Fuck you guys. Yeah, see, there are invisible walls here, and I can't just, like, go to that one, because you're meant to go to the other one, the one to my left. Yeah, see, I'm scrolling down because I can't scroll up. My fucking D-pad's busted. And another one that's filled with darkness. That'd be pretty cool, though. You had a treasure chest filled with darkness. I don't know how you're gonna get the darkness back in it, but... It'd be pretty cool to show you, pretty cool conversation starter. Dark Ring. I wonder what that does. Oh, maybe it's kind of like the Inferno Band, but with better dark resistance. And the last treasure chest before I... Oh, cool, another one that's just darkness. Ouch. Thanks, Donald. Appreciate it. Power up. power up. Awesome. Should I use some of these? Yeah, I think I'm gonna use some of these now. Might as well. Before I go into that swirling abyss of darkness right in front of us. And yeah, that's it. Oh, so if you see right underneath there, right underneath Water Gleam, I have a postcard and some torn pages. Next episode, I'm going to be getting the rest of the postcards and the rest of the torn pages, so that'll probably be a really short... I'll probably upload this part and the next part, like, on the same day, because they're, next episode will be really short. It'll just be me cutting to, like, you know, the locations of the other postcards and torn pages. See, this is the third one that I fought in the game. See, if you just hide underneath him, you won't take any damage from it. I'm so glad that Heartless don't have reproductive organs. Be kind of awkward. Come on, boys. Let's get him. I never can dodge that attack. Ugh. I have the worst timing. Oh, I didn't know that. When you do strike rage, even if the platform underneath you moves, you just stay there in the air. That's pretty cute. Yeah, you see, you only get 480 experience for beating him. That's so awful. He's like a mini-boss. How does a mini-boss only give me 480 experience? Freaking Yuffie in the, Yuffie in the Pegasus Cup gives you more XP than that. I mean, like, about the same. This area is just daunting. Wonder where that Ansem fella went. And then just skip it. This area looks huge, but it's actually not as big as it looks. And so if you put those haste gummies on your ship, you'll actually fly a lot faster. Still debating on whether or not I should do a gummy mission. You can see I'm trying to show off this. Like, it's pretty big. It's a pretty big area in the game. I think it might be the biggest area in the game. I'm not 100% sure. Like, biggest is in, like, you know, just the amount of space with no load zones. But you can explore it pretty fast. I mean, there's not too much to see. Unless you like, you know, running around and having little sparklies on your feet. But, you know, there are a couple of treasure chests lying around, so make sure you keep your eyes out for them. You can't actually get back to that part unless you exit and go to the beginning again. So these parts are pretty cool. Where there's these just like glowing pits of light from the bottom coming from like out of nowhere. And what they do is they teleport you to the worlds that you've been for some reason. You don't have to do this. This is entirely optional. I'm just doing it to show it off and to get the experience from it. There are treasure chests in here though, so that might be worth it, like if you want a double. See, like, I got really lucky and I got two Omega Arts right away. That treasure chest over there right in front, I think it gives you another Brave Warrior that you get from fighting the... what do you call it? The Traverse Town boss. The armor. I know, fucking... I got tired of fighting all those big bodies, so I just, like, fucking Strike Raid. Strike Raid's really good for the fat bodies. So if there's any item that you get from a boss that you really like and you want another one of it, like here, this is gonna be Brave Warrior, watch. Yeah, see? So if you really like Brave Warrior and you wanted another one, like, come here and get another one. And you'll see in some of these other worlds that, some of these other portals that you go through, the treasure chest in there will give you, another one of whatever boss, whatever the boss of that world drops, it'll give you another one of it. Like here in Wonderland, you get the Ifrit's Horn. So I should pick up another Ifrit's Horn in here. Like that treasure chest right there should be an Ifrit's Horn. I was gonna go open the chest right away, but, like, of course there's more Heartless to defeat. There's always more Heartless to defeat. Yep. But everything has its purpose. You know, if you were to look up, you could look up, like, the best optimization, the best equipment, the best keyblade to fight each boss, and you'd have a lot easier time. I'm just really stubborn and like doing things my own way. Because some of the bosses are really easy if you use some of the, like this part right here. It's super easy if you just summon Simba. If you were to, just, you know, scroll the magic, scroll down to summons, summon Simba. Like, this part's really easy, because you just charge up his shot, and every time you use a charged shot, he'll just, like, kill every enemy in the map, like, and then it'll spawn the next wave, do the same thing, third wave, same thing, just... basically a 1-2-3 and the area's cleared. But I don't mind fighting these guys. I like to get my hands dirty myself. Nice. Spirit gems, those will come in handy really soon. Cause I'm still gonna put together my Ultima Weapon episode. And, of course, we have these guys. So, I can't remember what the chameleon gives you. I'm not sure. Oh, I think they just give you Sabor's item. The white thing that Goofy's currently holding. Man, these guys are nothing now. They gave me such a hard time when I... when I played through this the first time. Those extra couple levels really do make a lot of difference. Fuck you, monkey. No! No! Oh, okay, he's still here. He just brought a couple more buddies for me to deal with. Sometimes I run into those banana peels on purpose just to pick up the money, but I've got so much money right now, it's kind of ridiculous. And I'm gonna get more money. I'm gonna get a lot more money soon anyway, because I have a lot of grinding to do to try and find all the ultimate weapon ingredients. Not for the ultimate weapon itself, but you need a lot of ingredients to. You need a lot of ingredients to unlock the recipe for the ultimate weapon. Yeah, White Fang. I like the White Fang, but for my purposes, it's just not for this playthrough. So I'm like, here, Goofy, you take it. It kind of goes in order. Because yeah, after you go to Deep Jungle, then you come to Agrabah. And, yeah, I'm not sure. I'm not sure where the treasure chest in this one is. If it's right in front of my face, I'll get it. But if not, like, I don't really want any more of these. If I can get a third Omega Arts, like, yeah, I'll do it, but for the most part, I don't need. Oh, a level up. Nice. Yeah, I couldn't find it. Or, let me say that I didn't want to find it. I like dodge rolling through those. Like, I don't know why, I think it's cool. So, again, if you use magic to deal the final blow to these guys, they won't explode into the little ones, but it's okay, I don't mind fighting them. A little bit more experience never hurt anybody. This upwards current's killing me. You know, these guys use thunder magic, but you can still use thunder magic on them. It's a little weird. Ooh, treasure chest. Come on, this. Donald, you can't take care of that guy? Jesus, it's one enemy. This is why I don't trust the NPCs. Oh, yeah, that's awesome. An AP up? Definitely use that. Interesting choice. Come on. Come on. The mummy heartless can be a little bit annoying sometimes. But I mean, for the most part, they're not that bad. They're pretty easy. It's just when they start fucking jumping around all over the place. Such a time waster. That was pretty sweet. How I tech that, like, glowing energy ball that they throw out. The flying heartless are pretty bad. Hurley circlet. Pretty sure that gives you immunity to, well, not immunity, but resistance to, you know, all elements. Plus, I think Holy Circlet increases your AP and gives you elemental resistance. So it's pretty nice if you're doing a magic build. Now this area's empty. Here we go. Normally the Heartless can't wait to come out and fight you. What, that was it? That was literally it, so I just cut. I just cut to the end, because... so disappointing. So here, that's the green one, that's the 100-acre wood. I'm just gonna be skipping it. Because you literally go inside, and then there's nothing there. But... fuck you, Invincibles. It's nice that I got the Invincible frames while I was doing Strike Raid so I didn't get hit with this freaking little Ring of Darkness. Once born of the heart and darkness, devoid of hearts, ravage all worlds and bring desolation. Seize all hearts and consummate the great hearts, all hearts to be one, one heart to encompass all. Realize the destiny, the realm of kingdom hearts, the great darkness sealed within the great heart. Progeny of darkness, come back and blah blah blah, blah 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 blah. The door to darkness tied to blah blah blah. None shall pass but shadows, returning to the darkness, once born of the heart and darkness, hunger for... blah blah blah. More bullshit written by Anza. That's basically the gist. I think I would have rather had a third Omega Arts than a Mega Elixir. Mega Elixirs I just don't think are that great. Cause Donald and Goofy always have really high MP. Cause Goofy has MP rage and keeps getting his ass beat. So he has plenty of MP and then he keeps us supplied. So I don't really see why. I can see regular elixirs, because I use them for boss battles, but not the Megas. At least not for me. See, when I was a little kid, this boss seemed really out of place to me. And you have to fight him, because So the deal is that once you beat the Hollow Bastion area, then that hole opens up, you jump down, and surprise, this guy is here. And, you know, I'm pretty sure there's only... He's got a few attacks, and some of them do, like, that one will fuck you up. When he summons fire from the depths of hell, that'll fuck you up if you're not careful. And it's really, like, I ran right into it. It has different intensity. So right there, that was kind of like the baby version. Then he's got flamethrower. A demon spawn used flamethrower. He's pretty easy. If you don't, you know, as long as you keep your wits about you. Come on, Donald. The flamethrower attack's pretty easy to dodge. Just kind of fly behind him. Try to stay behind him and attack the nape of his neck. Fuck, I got hit 3 times with that? Thankfully, Goofy has all those potions. So, basically, fight this guy like as if you were fighting a titan from Attack on Titan. Just attack the back of his neck. Oh yeah, also, my shortcut, my R1 is busted, so I can't use the shortcut menu. So that's why I'm in... So, I'm at a disadvantage. Don't, like, kill me for it. And he's almost gone. Oh yeah, he summons these little, like, whirlwind things. This, like, wind magic kind of crap. They, like, track you. But they're pretty easy to avoid. Oh, he's gonna summon fiery. Oh, he's got fire punch too, huh? Ah, fuck. Damn it. No, just get him. Fuck. He's not going down without a fight. He wants. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. That was close. Oh, we got Dolan and Goofy too. He really turns on the charm when he starts getting, like, low on health. Come on, I only have just, like, 2 more combos. Ah, no! See how bad that was? I had to scroll through, like, twice. Shit! Just, so close, just do it. So, that's, like, the big one. That'll fucking kill your shit if you're not careful. It's kind of like non-stop fire and wind magic from this guy. And, yeah, that was... Fuck! 3 times? This should help. Donald! Oh shit, I don't have any MP. Or... Oh shit. Holy hell, this guy's gonna be... Will you let me attack you for a second? Holy crap. He's had less than half a health bar for like 5 minutes. I haven't had... You know what? I'm just gonna go for it. I'm just gonna go... Yeah, there we go. Holy hell, that part at the end? It took forever. Ah, die, you scumbag. Die. Super Glide! Awesome. I love Super Glide. Yeah, I'm cracking my knuckles. You hear popping noises? Because I'm cracking my knuckles. Yeah, you don't want to see me scroll, go through all that part, so I just cut it. This area is pretty cool. Goals for my next room decor. Whenever I redecorate my room, I'm gonna decorate it like that. Like these walls. I freaking love Halloween. You guys have no idea. Ouch! Ah, fuck, another one of these guys? It's the fourth or fifth one. See what I mean? Hopefully the next part, the new PlayStation controller came in, so I won't be at such a disadvantage. Ah, crap. As soon as I get on this guy. Nice, that one you missed. And I didn't dodge it. Again. Fuck. Go. Go get him. Oh shit. See, now that one only gave me 450. Surprise this goat. Ha! Sweet revenge. There's so much happening on the screen at once, it's a little hard to comment on things as they're happening because I'm paying attention to the game. I'm trying not to die. I'm also trying to, kill these guys. And just, there's so much happening that once you comment on one thing, like 10 other things have just happened. So these guys have a lot of, like, gimmicky attacks. Like, combined, they can fuck you up, but if it's just one of them, you're fine. Great. There's more of these guys? Shit. Oh, Goofy got KO'd. There we go. Heal! motherfucker. And of course, strike rate barely reaches it. Open up. There we go. Ah, I forgot to equip Super Glide. Ah, not more invisibles. Nice. Another gale. I'm probably still gonna have to come back here for more gales, but that's fine. Fuck. It's too far away, I couldn't reach it. Another wave? Holy hell. Man, I really wish I had Trinity limits right now. Please, yes. That took a little bit. But alright guys, that's gonna wrap it up for this episode.